We've had just the great games here today. The last game, you talk about parity. A team with 10 wins almost takes down the number one seed in the tournament.
View aggressive lease and finance offers at GreaterTwinCitiesHondaDealers.com. Here's a look in for Maple Grove. That's Sam Excellent. Hoff, and they get out front. They score!
What a play. A great play coming down the wing by Hoff. He goes right around. It looks like he's going to be stopped. Puck slides to the side, and Kukkonen, who had 5 goals during the year, quickly puts this Maple Grove team up ahead as he's all alone on the side of the net. Look at this move by Hoff, driving to the net, gets stopped, but the puck bounces out off the backboard, and there is Kukkonen right there, and just was able to put it in the empty net. Great speed Hoff shows right there, and boy, that puck comes right off the boards. And Hoff quickly puts it out to Kukkonen, who just beats his falling goaltender.
Yeah, and Kukkonen was falling down because he was sliding back the other way. Had just enough room to tuck it in. 20 seconds in, what a start for Maple Grove.
And we saw it earlier afternoon, 2 goals get scored off the draw.
Another face-off win. Hoff able to keep it away from Del Greco, and he scores! Sam Hoff sneaks it in, 2-0 Crimson.
Well, another faceoff draw. That's 4 goals we've seen off the faceoff here today in different games. And this one had a little more work than just a faceoff and shot, because Sam Hoff had to make some moves, as he did earlier when he set up the first goal. Watch him at this time. A little move here, and it goes back into the shooting area. And as he gets there through a screen, he puts it in. Goaltender looking for it, couldn't find it. Hoff takes that shot. Seems to deflect maybe off a Grand Rapids player into the far corner. And Maple Grove up 2-0 early in this first period ahead of Grand Rapids. There he is.
For Hain, Heitkamp up top. Umbrella set up here for Grand Rapids. And Hain, he scores! Gavin Hain has got Grand Rapids on the board. It's 2-1.
Well, Hain just sort of looked the goaltender away. He's coming in, and he's looking at the far side as if he's going to pass it across ice to his winger, Miller. And it just, at the last second, he pulls the trigger, beats the goaltender, Hayter, on the short side. Watch this. He looks at the far side. He's going to give it to the point, gets it, moves down, and looks the far side right there, then shoots on the short side. And, boy, he shot a bullet up high and right in the upper corner. Here's the look right there, and then he lets fly with that shot.
10 seconds left in their power play, up to the point. Anderson into the corner. Reversal to the opposite end. Jumping down is Stampahar, top of the circle. Shot scores!
What a rocket. Another one on the short side up high. Stampahar took a look. He was going to pass the puck. Then he sees an opening, and he lets fly and tied it up. Stampahar has had 14 goals this year, just got his 15th. What a good-looking power play Grand Rapids has had here tonight. 2 power play goals, another one short and up high.
We have a brand new hockey game, 2-2.
So if you're Maple Grove, don't be taking penalties against this hockey club. Pretty excited bench.
Kelly high sticking at 10
to the middle.
37.
For Graber. In the middle for Bergson. They score!
Boy, oh boy, were they moving that puck around pretty well.
Another power play goal for Grand Rapids. They have been money on the man advantage.
Well, look at how many passes they made. 4 passes. Here's one. Here's 2. It goes down here and then back out right in front of Burns. And right here, he's going to knock it out of the air right in the net. But good puck movement. And then right out of the air here. Look at that deflection. Right in. His body goes in. He didn't throw it in. He didn't kick it in. And so that puck is be a counted goal right there.
Working up the right wing. Brings it across, hands it off to Anderson. Scores! Stuck one through! That's 4 unanswered now for Grand Rapids.
Well, I think Hayter'd like to have that one back. It was a nice little play from Miller over to Anderson. He moves in, he takes a look, he gets it on the right side of the net, the far side, and just seems to catch part of the goalie's pad. And another quick goal we've seen all day long. We've had these goals scored in bunches. And there's a second one scored after a short time after Grand Rapids had taken the lead. Let him take a look. Finally sees it. Goalie didn't get all of it and just gets right through. Micah Miller, nice little backhand pass here. Look at Anderson. Look, come in. Hits him in the shoulder and just
powered it through.
Yep.
50 seconds after the Burnson goal gave them the lead. Anderson's got to shoot.
You don't want go too many for the wide open net. Hayne, especially with that rocket he's got.
Burnson ends up with it out in the front for McLaughlin, and he scores! Well, they missed on the earlier drive, but they kept at it. And that's now five in a row here for Grand Rapids, and they've opened up a 5-2 lead.
Well, that line, McLaughlin, Hayne, and Miller, they just are dangerous every time they get out in the ice. And when they get in your offensive zone, they really make things happen. After a good opportunity by those guys, you see right here a lot of hard work when they come up with the puck here. Look at McLaughlin right there. Good fake, comes around and puts it in. Very, very good puck hand coordination with these guys, all of them.
Hayter made the initial save, as you saw with the pad right there, came right back to him. And McLaughlin, his 19th of the season for Hawks in the orange, and it's Maple Grove in the white uniforms. Stayskull gets a stick on it here early going, and it comes right to the doorstep. They score! That's an answer! Justin Kelly! He scored 20 seconds into the game, and this one 18 seconds into the third.
They get some fast goals, don't they? I mean, this is unbelievable. You just can't imagine how they do it. But Huff puts pressure on. Justin Kelly goes around the net, around the front of the net. The goalie doesn't know where the puck is, I don't think. Look at him.
Yeah, rolled off.
After
him.
This goes, he's not sure where it is.
There it
just
is.
Seemed to go right through the inside of him.
But not out, held in by Nygaard, still in. Now here comes Miller. It's a two-on-one the other way with McLaughlin. McLaughlin and Miller in shot, score! Blake McLaughlin, 6-3 Thunderhawks.
Well, he had a two-on-one, and the defenseman took away the other guy, and actually it looked like McLaughlin had faded to his left too far, but he still put it in the short side, his second goal of the evening. And boy, oh boy, what a nice play. You get caught 2-on-1 against this team. I know you have to take chances when you're on that far, but look, he comes in a short side, still was able to get it in. Defenseman played the guy perfectly because he took away the guy with the better angle. The goalie's got to take the shooter, and that's who scored the goal.
Yeah, Jack Kelly, the defenseman, getting back. He took away the pass and left McLaughlin with the only option he had. And he did the best of that option by Tyler Borsch. Got blocked back onto the stick of Huff to the right wing. Dances in, feeds it, score! Jaden Walsh, the beneficiary of a great Sam Huff play, and this is a two-goal game.
Well, I got to tell you, that was a remarkable play by Huff. Look at the puck control. Look at how he makes the moves. Look at the fake, and look at the open net he gives to Walsh. Watch this. Right in. Looks like he's going to go in. Everybody's overplaying him. And all he does is slide across to Walsh. Walsh got a wide open net. Good move, good fake, good pass, good goal.
The Grand Rapids heading to the semifinals. What a comeback here for Grand Rapids. They fall behind 2-0. Maple Grove with a wonderful start. They were up 2-0 the first 4.5 minutes of this hockey game, but then 5 unanswered. And then Grand Rapids able to fend off a Maple Grove rally. Well, you can tell how difficult it's for those guys, they have to wait to head out on the ice. And here they come, the Eden Prairie Eagles and the Grand Rapids Thunderhawks. Great matchup. We mentioned they played earlier. It was a 3-1 Grand Rapids at the Edina Holiday Classic. Olson to the dot, shot off the blocker, stays goal again, yeah. And they score off the rebound.
Well, I'll tell you, that line worked for it. That's Lesko. Lesko and Olson had a couple of opportunities. Olson taking a deep around the net. They kept the pressure on. That puck's bouncing in front, and Lesko backhanding that puck, bouncing right into the net, giving Eden Prairie lead. Watch this. There's a shot right on goal by Lesko, and he gets his own rebound that's bouncing there and puts it right in. There's Lesko fighting off the check, taking the shot, bounces where in the air, and there it is. The puck's still bouncing when he backhands it past the goaltender.
Pialski actually reached for it with his stick, and if he would have made contact with it, he would have touched it with a high stick, and then his teammate touched it next, but fortunate there at the dasher to knock it down. Heitkamp, Miller, Stampahar is in low below the dot, goes to the backside, yeah. They score! That was knocked in by the defenseman, it looked like. He was trying to feed McLaughlin, but it's a power play goal with still 3 seconds left on that first penalty. We're tied at one.
Well, the pass coming across, Stampahar is trying to feed his guy on the far side, shoots that puck across the net. Defenseman trying to defend there, inadvertently deflects it in. Those things happen. You see standing all those McLaughlin down on the left, but that goes right in off Middlestead, and unfortunately that puck goes right in the net. Those things happen. We've seen a lot of deflections like that, and that one is Middlestead trying to stop the pass. Just got deflected in, and we still got 1:13 to go in the second power play.
If he doesn't stop that or make contact, Prudiak, though, found a guy. They flip it in. Johannes goes right back after it. He shoots it in from a bad angle. That one almost pinballed in, but again, Stayskull stopping it and covering it.
Yeah, Stayskull had to hold his area right there. He was tight against the pipe, and had he just moved a little bit, they could have shoved that puck in. But you see Blachowiak in front fighting for it. But here's a shot from the side from Johannes, and he is... putting that right on net, and you see the loose puck, but the goaltender stayed tight to that pipe, and that's what you have to do. Stasko really
throws it off the boards. Rebound Grand Rapids. Steffen for Graber. Shot. Scores!
What a good goal by Graber. I'll tell you, that puck seemed to bounce over the defenseman's stick. And as it does, Graber's coming with speed, and he's also coming on his forehand. He's on the off wing. He's the centerman. He cuts to the left side, and he's got a 6 feet better shooting angle because the puck's on the inside of him. And watch this. The puck's going to bounce over, and he's able to see the opening there. And he puts it right in the far side. That puts Grand Rapids up 2-1. Good effort there by Graber. That puck just bounces away, and look at that shot.
Don't forget a little help there also from one of your favorite players, Jack Burnson.
Yeah, he
kind of directed it off of that initial pass, it looked like, at center ice.
He's had a terrific tournament as well.
Stayskull. What a play by Middlestad. Now he's got it again. Takes the shot himself, and then it ends up to Jensen. He scores!
Well, they switched the lines back up again. That time they came back with Middlestad again, this time against Graber's line, and Middlestead made a great play, first of all, that they didn't score on. That one was as cute as it gets. Watch his great back pass right here. Great, great drop pass, and Rudrud misses. Then we follow up the puck, and here's where they do score. Here's Middlestead again. He's going to backhand that shot through. The rebound after defenseman blocks it goes right over to the side, and Jensen just puts it away. Jensen's missed a few, but now he says, now I finally got teams. It's almost like they're unsung heroes, because not seeing their name a lot, but they are playing well.
Grand Rapids has Graber. Oh, he was hauled down. They score! They get it to the middle. Graber went down, and it looks like Connor Steffen is the one who put it in, and Grand Rapids has broken the tie.
Boy, that was an effort from that line. And as you said, Steffen right from the slot after the play breaks down. They get it to the middle, and Stepan's coming with speed. He put that shot right on the net quickly before Winston could respond. Watch this, just battling along the left side. Now that puck comes right out. It was just a great, great play by Graber to get that puck. Look at him. He fights through the check, goes down, centers it, and Stepan didn't stop it at all. He just went right at it. But what a play by Graber.
Yeah, he kept it alive. He had a defender on him. A little bit of a grab. He went down, kept the puck going twice. It does finally sneak out. Rudrud then right under the stick of Mittelstadt. He's in. Shot glove by Stastny.
Well, Coach Klatt said before the game, I really like the way our goaltender's playing. And he is right. 42 saves now. Grabs another one. Holds on to it.
Had to find that one through a screen. It looked like here's a Mittelstadt shot. Yep, right there.
He's 6'4".
Eden Prairie power play. Lakoviak. Left wing centers. Lieberman off the pad of Stastny. Lakoviak the rebound. 10 seconds left. Mittelstadt. Oh, and he centered it, and it got past Sullivan. Out to center. That's going to do it. The Grand Rapids Thunderhawks will play for a state championship. Another great game, Lou.
Wow. What an effort. What an effort by Grand Rapids and by Eden Prairie. But boy, oh boy, we expected a tremendous game, and did we get it? And that goaltender was absolutely sensational. 49 shots, 47 saves, just enough to win 3-2, and a great effort.
There's your player of the game, brought to you by Highway Federal Credit Union.
Well, there's no doubt about player of the game. What an effort he put forth today. He should stop everything coming his way. And he's got a terrific future. Look at right there, Mittelstadt. He just never quit. He kept going. He kept doing everything he could.
It's title time again in St. Paul tonight. These are the Grand Rapids Thunderhawks. They come into the state tournament as the number 5 seed tonight. They can win their first title in 37 years. They knocked off the number 1 team to get here. The Moorhead Spuds can make history tonight. This is the 14th time they've been in the state tournament, the 8th time in the title game. The Spuds are still looking for their first championship.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 73rd annual Minnesota State High School Boys Hockey Tournament. Tonight's AA state title game features the champions of Section 7 with a record of 22-7-1, the Grand Rapids Thunderhawks. Against the champions of Section 8 with a record of 24-3-3, the Moorhead Spuds.
Lance Leonard with an outstanding record, only 3 losses this season when you look at that, this kid has had a remarkable year, and he's going to have a remarkable night, because in the other net, you look at this guy, Zach Stastny. What a job he's done down the stretch, and last night, 47 saves.
Cole O'Connell against Gavin Hayne on the opening draw. Top lines are out there, and we are underway. Gavin Hayne into the corner here to Blake McLaughlin, future Gopher.
Boys, he looked good handling the puck.
Back up high, Heitkamp blocked again. Loose puck, though, to Hayne, and he scores! He dials up a slapper, and he powers it through Leonard. Power play goal, 1-0 Thunderhawks.
It looked like Leonard had it, but he didn't have enough of it. And I guess you'd have to see the key in that play is watch how fast Hayne gets rid of that puck. Really quickly, that's the key. It looked like the puck was going to get thrown down the ice. It was saved. Hayne just got a stick on it.
Low angle shot. Tried to get to it earlier, still got a shot off. Now Hayne with some speed. McLaughlin, shot, scores! McLaughlin, a laser from the top of the near circle. 2-0.
Well, you had a change, and so because of it, you had a 4-on-2 for Grand Rapids. Look at this, a little drop pass, a shot. Look at that, 4-on-2. You see it right there? Part of it was the transition, part of it was the line change, and Moorhead got caught shorthanded, and a smart play right inside the post. You could hear it right in there, right off the pipe and inside. What a great execution by Grand Rapids to put themselves up 2-0.
McLaughlin's 21st of the season. Hayne earlier here this period. That top line getting physical as well for Grand Rapids. Little lead pass. Can Moorhead get to it? Dronin tried to. He goes down to the doorstep. Stayskull is up against that pipe to hold the puck out. And then some extracurriculars. A dust up after the whistle. And the fan cam is brought to you by 45 TV. And is there anybody having more fun? I don't think there is than Dr. Chuck Ells.
I got to tell you, it's electric in this building tonight. It's unbelievable, the emotion, the excitement, the enthusiasm. You can feel the adrenaline all the way up here. And thus far, we've had McLaughlin, Hayne, and Miller come through for Grand Rapids. If you're a Moorhead fan, you know that Grand Club O'Connell and Stets are not going to be denied tonight. So we got a lot of excitement ahead of us here.
And everybody gets pumped up. It's like the old days. In is Hayne, shot saved by Leonard.
Yes.
Final minute of the first period. 2-0 Thunderhawks. One last chance here for Frisch. In tries to split the defense. Still able to trickle it in on Stayskull. That's some determination. Stets is there behind the net. Reversed, and there's your horn. That's the end of the first period. And Lou, a great first period for Grand Rapids.
A great first period for them. A great first period for the fans because of the excitement, the speed. And you saw goal scorer McLaughlin there. Grand Rapids leading 2-0.
In deep, Stets to O'Connell. Looks to center, trickling, and oh, right there was Larson. How good has Zach Stayskull been so far, keeping Moorhead off the board? Seen some minutes here in the second period. Stampahar sidesteps a defender. He's got a look, and that looked like it grazed off the post or the crossbar and out of play.
What a pass by McLaughlin to Graber getting under the box.
Oh, and Miller with a steal. Rebound just wide. I think Leonard may have directed that wide on a good look by Hayne after it was created by Micah Miller. Now bearing in Anderson. Scores!
Well, they applied pressure, like you said, Jim, right from the penalty box, and they never let him out of their zone. And I think it was that Anderson or Hayne? I thought it was Hayne.
Hayne
right in front, the leader, the captain, the second of the night, killing the penalty. Hayne McLaughlin, they did an outstanding job there, stayed on the ice. McLaughlin with a great lead pass to Graber. They never let that puck out of the zone with some strong forechecking to get a turnover in front. And that was it. You got a good shot here coming in from the point.
Hands it back to Hayne, Gavin Hayne, in low to Miller. Up high, Heitkamp shot, blocker save, Leonard, he doesn't know where it is. And swept out of danger by the Spuds, but not out of the zone with Miller getting it to the net, and then it's Hayne, he scores! Hat trick for Gavin Hayne!
What a night that this kid is having, what a year he's had. Boy, oh boy, you couldn't ask for anything more from your captain, your leader. This is what Trent Clatt wanted, and has he been tenacious? He's been absolutely all over the ice. He thinks the game, he sees the game. Tough spot to hit, but he hit it.
And now the Thunderhawks up 4-0. Now tapped the other way by Graber. Graber with Steffen. 2-on-1 as they hurry in. Shuffle. Oh, and a save by Leonard.
An excellent save there on a poke check by the goaltender.
That's,
you'll see right here.
Yeah, Steffen too. I mean, the timing on the pass was perfect, but Leonard's timing too was perfect. The goaltender. Look at that.
That's right. Just right under the chin. Well, McLaughlin and Hayne have done a masterful job killing penalties thus far.
Frisch for McConnell. Gets some space. Here's a shot. He scores!
Well, who do you expect to get it? Just a kid you thought would get it. Rantlett with a great wrist shot from the side. What a bullet. That kid has really got some skills, and he gets his 33rd of the year. And looking at the far corner and hitting it.
That is just what the doctor ordered here for the Moorhead Spuds.
And that McLaughlin, when he gets it, he's going to make the right move.
He's got it there, but then he coughed it up. And O'Connell will grab it. Top of the circle, to the back door, right back, two steps, and he scores! 4-2!
How about that passing play? Three-way passing play, leaving the goaltender with no opportunity, 8 seconds to go. Here's the turnover, then the pass across, and watch this, just a nice little play right there. Pass across right here, open net, tic-tac-toe, and that's all she wrote. 4-2. What a big, big goal at the right, appropriate time for Moorhead. If you're a Moorhead fan or a Moorhead teammate, you gotta love it.
Sent by Grand Rapids, McLaughlin will look for it, try for it as the horn sounds. And Moorhead down 4-0. They have answered, and they have made it very interesting as we get ready for the third.
Well, we've seen scores in bunches in this tournament. Every day we've had it, we had it again. And
Dayskull was there, didn't have to worry about it because he had Stampahar.
That's right, and Stampahar has been tower of strength tonight for Grand Rapids.
McLaughlin, steal. Forced wide by Parker, gives it to... Oh, and a score by Micah Miller, who maintained possession of the puck, and he scores. 5-2 Grand Rapids.
Well, from deep in the corner, McLaughlin made a great pass out to Micah Miller. It looked like Micah Miller was going to be checked. Actually, the puck got just knocked off his stick a bit, but he stayed with it and let a shot go in the far corner. Micah Miller getting on the board. The full first line now was scored here tonight for Grand Rapids.
Moorhead will be sure here, and it's grabbed by Larson. Larson jumps in along the goal line, backside, and where did that one end up? How did that one not go in? The whistle blew. It was under Stayskull. It looked like, Lou.
Well, here's the play, an excellent play by Larson, right across, and looked like Stets put it in. We couldn't see it. Okay, now you got to be looking at the puck from when you hear. Yeah,
it was.
The whistle went before that puck went over. Just an exciting game, terrific period.
Grab by Holtgrew, in shot scores! Moorhead back to an N2.
What a rocket that Holtgrew shot in the short side. I'm not sure if Stachel could pick that up at first. But boy, oh boy, was that a big goal for Moorhead. 7:45 to go as Holtgrew checks the clock as well. Just came off the bench. When he got that puck and he gets over the blue line, just came from the line change. Well, look at that. Short side, up top. Big goal for Moorhead, cutting that lead down.
Here's your attendance for tonight's.
Ladies and gentlemen,
wow. Look at that. 19,109 tonight. 28,000 for the day. Today, 476.
476.
What a wonderful day of hockey we've had here at the XL.
Ooh. Rung up high, Howell, a one-time shot, saved by Stayskull, and the rebound at the side of the net, Stayskull's stick.
Comes off to the side, look at his Rantcliffe reaching, but Stayskull with his glove, able to get on top of that before that puck was pushed in by Rantcliffe, and goes right to the side of the net.
There's the shifty Rantcliffe to hold it in, it comes to the point, and they can't hold it in, empty net the other way, and look who has it, it's McLaughlin into the empty net! Empty net goal for Grand Rapids. The lead is 3.
Well, you're looking at a tremendously happy coach, Trent Platt. Boy, is he thrilled as you look at the goal scorer, McLaughlin, who fought his way along the boards to get that loose puck, get over the line and put it in the empty net, essentially to seal this win for Grand Rapids, even though you got 1:16 to go.
As the Thunderhawks start to make some thunder on their end of the rink, comes back to neutral. Jaeger back in. 2 seconds. 1 second. That's it. The Halloween machine is back on top. It's a state championship for Grand Rapids. Celebrating a state championship, their first since 1980.
Watch this. The clock is not even at zero yet, and these guys are on the ice. I guarantee if you were showing the clock, there was a minute, 0.7. I was looking at them coming over the bench. They were ready to celebrate, and boy, did they ever. Wow, look at that goal. Look at them coming. Stuff going all over. It's so wonderful to see how excited these guys get, including their coaching staff right there. What a job they've done.
Will the captains please come forward to accept your state championship trophy? Grand Rapids High School finishes with a record of 23-7-1 and is the 2017 Minnesota State High School Boys AA State Hockey Champion.
The number 4 seed in the section. Did you guys have a chip on your shoulder when those section seedings came out?
Oh, definitely. You know, coach talked about it right from the get-go. You know, we were favorite at the start of the year, and we had our downs. But and then coming in the section, we were 4 seed. And we had a little chip on our shoulder, so we wanted to prove them wrong.
You know, talk about this guy right here, your line mate, Micah Miller, and how your coach put it on you guys to step up tonight. You end up with a hat trick. You guys end up together with 6 goals on that line.
Yeah, I couldn't have done it without him or Blake or any of the team. You know, this guy especially, he's fast and he's got everything. Blake passes the puck well, and I couldn't do it without anybody.
How about this guy, a junior, comes up with a hat trick in the state championship game?
Just unbelievable. Leader, you know, just natural goal scorer, does everything he does for the team. Is just, we just couldn't do it without him or any of the guys, like he said. Just a great hard worker, skill guy, just amazing.
How about your coach? He stepped down, comes back a couple days later, and now you guys are state champions. Talk about what it was like to play for a guy like Trent Klatt.
Just amazing. You know, you don't get lucky like that. Getting a high school coach as great as him. He's a great person. You know, all the boys love him, and he's just a great leader for this team. He's perfect for us.
What's it mean to you to have a guy like this? Now he's going to be moving on to be able to play like this, play with a guy like this for the last couple of years.
Well, playing with him for the last couple of years, couldn't ask for anything better. But now that he's moving on, it sucks. But he's gonna have a great future, and I'll see him in his future too.
Congratulations to both of you guys.
Thanks.
Just the game, it was a crowd, the enthusiasm, the electricity in the building, and this game, though it said 6-3 on the scoreboard.
The Grand Rapids Thunderhawks and head coach Trent Klatt. Louie, you brought it up. Trent Klatt, the first ever Mr. Hockey to coach a team to the state championship.
And can you imagine what's going through his mind? You know, he's had so many thrills in his career. And now when you get a thrill like this, you got to say, geez, where does this rank? And I guarantee you, for him, it ranks right at the top. People don't realize how important it is to the individuals that are taking part in this tournament to come out as a state high school champ. And there's one right there, and the coaching crew that he had, they're just ecstatic.
Let's let these guys take it out here.